Good morning. Okay, let us revise one more time. What are the rules for transfer to DRR and Debenture Redemption Reserve investment? So we'll divide these companies into three types. First is All India Financial Institution and Banking Companies. So whether listed or public issue or private placement, DRR is not required. And DRR investment is also not required. Then we'll come to other category called NBFC and HFC. Here the rules are slightly different for listed and unlisted. If it is a listed company, public issue, DRR is not required. But DRRI, Debenture Redemption Reserve investment, is required. For listed company private placement, DRR not required, DRRI required. But for unlisted NBFC or HFC, DRR is not required, DRRI is also not required. And then all other companies, listed company, public issue, DRR not required, DRRI required, private placement, DRR not required, and DRRI, and for unlisted company, DRR up to 10% of the value of debenture outstanding, and DRRI is also required. So if the question is silent, you can assume other companies. If the question is silent, what will you assume? Unlisted company. Other companies and unlisted company, and create 10% DRR and 15% DRRI. And you write a note accordingly. So now, what are the journal entries we pass in case of companies where we have to create DRR? For creating DRR, the entry is P&L account debit to DRR. And then after that, you have to make an investment. Entry for investment, DRR investment to bank. And then at the time of redemption of debenture, you will in cash or sell the investment. Entry will be bank to DRR investment. And amount due to debenture holders, debenture account debit to debenture holder account. And then payment debenture holders to bank. And then after that, balance in DRR is transferred to DRR account to general reserve. Okay. So today we'll see the application of these entries one more time. Come to question number 14. Question number 14. On 1st April 20X1, in MK Limited's book, and what is the status of MK Limited? Unlisted company, other than All India Financial Institution, Banking Company, NBFC and HFC. So which means we require DRR 10%, DRRI 15%. So on 1st April 20X1, there is a balance 9% debenture appeared with an opening balance of rupees 50 lakh divided into 50,000 fully paid debenture of rupees 100 each issued at par. So this is opening balance in debenture account. Interest on debenture was paid half yearly on 30th September and 31st March every year. So interest will be paid on 2 days. On 31st May 20X1, company purchased 8,000 debenture of its own at rupees 98 x interest per debenture. On the same day, it cancelled the debentures acquired. You are required to prepare necessary ledger accounts, including excluding bank account. Okay. Only one cancellation took place, one purchase which was cancelled, right? So I need to prepare a small working note for purchase of own debenture. So write one small working note, purchase of own debenture. Purchase of own debenture you have prepared. Format write down. Date. Interest accrued. Under that draw three columns. From to number of months, from to number of months, then face value, X interest. What is the interest rate in this question? 9%. Interest at the rate of 9% per annum. And the last column, write down cum interest. Last column, write down cum interest. First, I'll complete this working note 1, or you can give it a name, step 1. Step 1 or working note 1. So, under that you write, what is the date of purchase? 31st May. 20x1 interest accrued. Count the number of months. What are the two interest payment dates? The two interest payment dates are 31st March and 30th September. So 31st March, 30th September, and the purchase took place on 31st of May. So how many months have expired? 2 months have expired. So the interest will accrue for 2 months. Interest will accrue for 2 months, starting from which date? 1st April 20x1. Going up to 31st May 20x1. So this comes to 2 months. First you have to identify this. If this goes right, then it is right. 2 months. Last interest payment date till the date of transaction. Now tell me the face value of this debenture bought. 8 lakh 8000 debenture into 100 rupees. 8 lakh 8000 into 100, and this was purchased on X interest basis. So you multiply 8000 into 98. 8000 into 98 is how much? 7 lakh 84,000. And then interest paid. Take on your calculator 8 lakh into 9% into 2 by 12. Is it 12,000? So the total payment made will be 7 lakh 96,000. Now write one more step too. Interest paid on debentures. Which are the two dates on which we have to pay the interest? We have to pay interest on 30th September and 31st March. write three columns: due date, face value, interest at the rate of 9% per annum. Interest at the rate of 9% per annum. In our problem, there will be two times when you have to pay the interest. First, you have to pay interest on 30th September 20X1. 30th September 20X1. 30th September 20X1. What is the interest to be paid on 30th September 20X1? Question is open for you. What is interest paid on 30th September 20X1? 1 lakh? 1,89,000? Opening balance was 50 lakh. Out of 50 lakh, 50 lakh, 8 lakh, this 8 lakh, first working note, you have cancelled. 50 lakh minus 8 lakh. So what is the value of debenture outstanding now? 42 lakh. So write 42 lakh. For calculation purpose, take 42 lakh. 8 lakh is cancelled. What is cancelled? We will not pay interest on that. Now what you do? Take 42 lakh into 9% into 6 by 12. 1 lakh. So your answer is right. 1,89,000. After that, there is no further cancellation. Is there any other cancellation after that date? No further cancellation. If there is no further cancellation, your answer will be the same. We have to prepare books of account for 1 year, from 1st April 20X1 to 31st March 20X2. These are the questions they ask in the exam, just to test your knowledge for 1 year only. So in 1 year, they will check your ability to pass interest entry, own debenture entry, DRR entry, DRRI entry, etc. Okay. Now write down important ledger accounts. They have not specified which ledger account. Student has to decide, okay. So write down in the books of MK Limited. In the books of MK Limited. In the books of MK Limited. In the books of MK Limited, ledger accounts. Ledger accounts. Ledger accounts. First write down under that 1. Give them number also. First account is debenture account. 9% debenture account. Keep 5 to 6 lines blank. 6 lines blank. Date particular rupees. Date particular rupees. Then we'll also draw debenture redemption reserve account. Debenture redemption reserve account. Debenture redemption reserve account. Debenture redemption reserve account, you have written about 6 to 7 lines. Which other accounts you want? DRRI also. So write down debenture redemption reserve investment account, DRR investment account. DRR investment account. Draw about 6 to 7 lines. DRR investment account. We'll make the investment. Because it's a unlisted company and it is not a EIFI banking NBFC or HFC. So before the redemption begins, we'll have to create a DRR and DRRI. Okay. Then you write own debenture account. 6 line own debenture account. and we'll prepare one more account, interest on debenture account. Interest on debenture account. Interest on debenture account. Very important question. For 8 marks, they will ask you this question. Ready? First, you go to which account? First, we should go to which account? 9% debenture account? What is given to you? Opening balance. What is the date? 1st April 2021. By balance brought down 50 lakhs. By balance brought down 50 lakhs. And we will create a DRR also in this year. We will create DRR. How much DRR is required for a listed company? 10% of 50 lakh. 5 lakh. Entry. Penal account debit to DRR. Write down here DRR account, second number account 1420X1 by P&L account 5 lakh, 10% of 50 lakh, and we have to also make investment which is 15%. Come to third number account, DRR investment account 1420X1 to bank 15% into 50 lakhs 7,50,000. So first you have to complete the legal formalities. Right? Now we'll purchase own debenture on which date? 31st May. Entry for purchase of own debenture. Own debenture account debit X interest amount. Interest on debenture account debit to bank. So, own debenture account, debit side, 31st May 20X1 to bank account, into bracket step 1, go to step 1, check X interest amount, 7,84,000, interest on debenture account, 31st May 20X1 to bank account in bracket step 1, how much was that? 12,000. Are we supposed to prepare bank account also? No, because we don't know the opening balance. We don't know the opening balance, otherwise the second effect will go to bank account. Right. And then we are going to sell the debenture redemption reserve investment account. We are going to sell DRR investment because some portion of the investment have been redeemed. Some portion of debenture has been redeemed. So, proportionate amount we will transfer to general reserve and proportionate investment we will sell. So, how much investment you will sell? 15% of which number? 8 lakh. 15% of 8 lakh. 8 lakh. 15% of 50 lakh you have invested. Out of this 50 lakh, 8 lakh has been redeemed. So, we will sell proportionate investment. 15% of 8 lakh is how much? 15% of 8 lakh is how much? Louder. 1,20,000. Entry for sale of DRR investment. Bank account debit to DRR investment. So we'll come to DRR investment 31st May. I'll explain again. We are redeeming 8 lakh rupees out of this 50 lakh. So we are going to sell 15% of 8 lakh. So by bank, proportionate amount you have to redeem. It comes to 12 lakh. For calculation purpose, right? I'll improve. 1,20,000. 10 extra I have written. 1,20,000. 15% of 8 lakh. Okay? And how much amount we will transfer from DRR to general reserve? Out of this 50 lakh, we have redeemed 8 lakh. So 8 lakh multiplied by 10%. 8 lakh multiplied by 10%. 80,000. Entry. DRR account debit to general reserve. So every time you are going to cancel own debenture, you have to also transfer proportionate amount to general reserve, to general reserve, to general reserve. Calculation this time is simple, 10% of 8 lakh. How much is that? 80,000. Now we are going to cancel our own debenture. What is the face value of own debenture? 8 lakh. Entry for cancellation. Entry for cancellation. Debenture account debit to own debenture. Debenture account debit to own debenture. Date, same date, right? 31st May. 20X12. Own debenture. Amount is equal to 8 lakh face value. Okay. Contra effect, own debenture account. Own debenture account, 31st May, 20X1. By 9% debenture. Is it 9% debenture? 8 lakh. By 9% debenture, 8 lakh. But this own debenture account is not telling. There is a difference on the debit side. So now we will write down to profit on cancellation. Write down neatly to profit on cancellation. 16,000. To profit on cancellation, 16,000. To profit on cancellation, 16,000. So this account you can close. After this, there is no transaction here. In your exam, they may give you 2 or 3 purchase of own debenture and cancellation. Accordingly, you have to just repeat it. Now, we have to just pass entry for interest payment. When was the interest paid? Interest was paid on 30th September and 31st March. Amount is same. So entry will be interest account debit to bank. 30th September 20X1. To bank. To bank account. Figure you take from step 2. 1,89,000. Same entry repeat on 31st March 20X1. To bank account. X2 now. 1,89,000. Step 2 figure. All entries are over. Start closing one by one. Go to debenture account. How will you close debenture account on 31st March 2000 X2? To balance, carry it down. Is how much? 42 lakh. Take total of both sides. Then how will you close DRR account? 31st March 20X2. What will you write here? 2. Balance. Carry it down. How much is that? 4 lakh? 4 lakh 20,000. Total is how much? 5 lakh. Total is 5 lakh. And then DRR investment account, is it already closed? No. There is some balance. 31st March 20X2. Buy. Balance. Carry it down. 6 lakh 30,000. Take total. 7,50,000. Own debenture account. Tallied. And what about interest account? 31st March 20X2 buy. Profit and loss account. Total. 3,90,000. Check. Take total of both sides. 3,90,000. 3,90,000. Is right. In 9% debenture account. This account. This is 9% debenture account. Investment account. Okay. Investment. We have created investment. How much? 15% of 50 lakh. Out of 50 lakh, how much we have redeemed? 8 lakh. So once we redeem the debenture, or if we have to redeem the debenture, we have to sell the investment so that we can raise the funds and so that we can redeem the debenture. So since you have redeemed 8 lakh rupees only, so whatever investment we had created on 8 lakh, for 8 lakh, that much amount will be sold. So for 50 lakh rupees, 7,50,000 investment was made. Okay. For 50 lakh rupees, we have made an investment of 7,50,000. Now we are redeeming 8 lakh or cancelling 8 lakh. So once the debentures are cancelled, we can sell the investment. There is no need to put your money in a low interest paying security when it is not required. Okay. So that proportionate amount will come to what we calculated just now, 1,20,000. Okay. There is no point in parking your money in such a low interest paying securities, because you are paying high interest rate on debenture and you don't need to keep the money unless it is legally required. So company will sell proportionate investment. Okay. Any other query? No query. Okay. So just write some notes so that you'll understand. In case of partial redemption, in case of partial redemption or cancellation, in case of partial redemption or cancellation of debentures point 1 transfer on the screen transfer proportionate amount transfer proportionate amount from DRR account to general reserve and second sale proportionate amount sell proportionate amount of DRR investment sell proportionate amount of DRR investment right one more question is pending question number 15 question number 15 those who have the books come to question 15 YZ limited an unlisted company which is not a AIFI banking NBFC HFC so why they have given this information to create 10% DRR and 15% DRRI okay YZ limited had 16,000 12% debenture of rupees 100 each so what is the total value of debenture 16 lakh and what is the date 1st April 2021 and now these are redeemable on 31st March 2082. On 1st April 2081, falling balances appeared in the books of account. Investment in 2009% secured government bond of rupees 100 each. So what is 2000 into 100? Is it 2 lakh? Is it sufficient? Is it sufficient? 16 lakh into 15%. You need to maintain DRRI of 15% of 16 lakh. Ha, sorry, 15% of 2.4 lakh. But you have only 2 lakh minus 2. So you need to make additional investment of 40,000. DRR is 1 lakh. Is it sufficient? You need a DRR of 10% of 16 lakh. 1.60 lakh. Existing is only 1. So there is a shortfall of. Kitne ki kami hai? So you have to create a DRR of 60,000. In 14 number, opening balance was 0. So we have to make full investment and full DRR. In this question, some DRR and some DRR investment is already there. So you have to only create additional DRR and additional investment. Now the question is same like previous problem. Once you pass these two entries, interest on investment is received yearly. So this time you have to receive the interest on investment also. At 9% at the end of the financial year. Then you should ask a query in previous problem. We have not passed entry for interest received. Why? Guess. In question number 14, you have not passed entry for interest on investment. Interest rate is? Write one note in the previous question number 14. Note number 2. Note number 2, in the absence of previous question, in the absence of information about rate of interest on, in the absence of information about rate of interest on DRR investment, the same has not been accounted for, the same has not been accounted for. Okay, so back to question number 15. Next line is 2000 own debentures were purchased. 2000 own debentures were purchased on which date? Directly on 31st March 20X2, last date only, at an average price of rupees 99 and cancelled on the same date. On 31st March 20X2, the investments were realized at par. So whatever investment you will have, you will sell them. At what value? At par. And the debentures were redeemed. Remaining debentures will be redeemed. So this is a problem of cancellation plus redemption. Previous question was only cancellation. You are required to write up the following accounts. Which account? Following accounts only. 12% debenture account, DRR account, and DRR investment account. So interest account they have not asked only. So there is no need to calculate interest either on debenture issued by the company or investment. Right? Very easy problem. Draw these three accounts. This question has a small error. They have mentioned that own debentures were purchased at 99. Whether it is X interest or cum interest? So we'll assume X interest. We'll assume X interest. Because your answer will be different. If it is cum interest, then some interest is included inside it. So the cost will change. The X interest price will change. So first you write down these accounts. First they have asked us to prepare 12% debenture account. 12% debenture account. 12% debenture account. Keep 6 or 8 lines blank. Then you write DRR account. DRR account. Keep 6 or 8 lines blank. DRR account. And then they have asked us debenture redemption investment account. DRR investment account. Interest account is not asked. And one more account you draw below after DRR investment account. Own debenture account. Own debenture accounts you have drawn. 5 to 6 line. If you have any query, you ask me now on any question that we have solved. Any query? Today you revise the entire chapter. So what you do today as a homework, revise the entire chapter, all questions. We are ready with the format. First you put the opening balances wherever available. First April 2021. Buy balance brought down. Buy balance brought down 16 lakh. Buy balance brought down 16 lakh is given. In bracket write 16,000 into 100. 16,000 into 100. And then you come to DRR account. 1st April 2021. Buy balance brought down. What is the amount given in DRR investment DRR account? DRR is 1 lakh. And DRR investment account. 1st April 2021. 2 balance brought down. Is it 2 lakh? 2000 into 100. 2000, 9% secured government bond of 100 each. So 2000 into 100. Is it right? Say yes. Yes. Next. Now I will first pass entry for making additional investment and additional DRR. So what is the additional investment to be made? 40,000 rupees. Is it 40,000? Write down. 1st April 2021. 1st April 2021 to bank write. To bank. 40,000. And how will you get this 40,000? Bracket. 15% of 16 lakh minus 2 lakh. 40,000. And then you will also go to DRR account. You will transfer from P&L account to DRR account. By P&L account, how much? 60,000. Calculation right. 10% of 16 lakh minus existing balance 1 lakh. So you need to transfer 60,000 in this year because you have to redeem the debenture. Before redemption starts, balance in DRR should be 10% of the outstanding balance. Okay. In this question, there is one own debenture purchased. On which date? 31st March 2022. At what rate? 99. So, 2000 into 99 is how much? 1,98,000. Entry for purchase of own debenture. Own debenture account debit to bank. Own debenture account debit to bank. Work account number 4. Date write down directly 31st March 2022 to bank. And we are assuming it is X interest amount. So there is no problem. 2000 into 99. 1,98,000 is right. And then we are going to transfer proportionate amount from DRR to general reserve. What is the proportionate amount? Yeah, you can see, I'll tell you two things. One, either you can pass entire entry after completing the redemption, so one entry only, or you can pass two entries, one for cancellation and one for redemption. Okay, so we'll pass two entries, no problem. You can pass one also. So go to DRR account. You can pass one or you can pass two, because you are going to pass on the same date. Doesn't matter. 31st March 20X2. First, I will transfer proportionate amount to general reserve for cancellation of debenture. Into bracket on cancellation of debenture. Anybody wants to try? On 16 lakh rupees, we have created 1,60,000. On 16 lakh rupees, 1,60,000. On 2 lakh rupees, 20,000. On 2 lakh rupees, 20,000. Okay, you can just write here 2 lakh into 10%. 2 lakh into 10%. Don't worry, you can pass one entry also. If you find this is difficult, you can directly transfer entire 1,60,000 to general reserve. Coincidentally, the date of cancellation and the date of redemption both are same. But if they were different, then yes, you should pass two entries. Now, similarly, I'm going to sell investment also. Guess what is the value of investment I am going to sell on cancellation? Wait. One student will answer. What is the value of investment you are going to sell? On 16 lakh rupees face value, we created investment of 2,40,000. Now we are cancelling debenture of face value 2 lakh. Now we are cancelling debenture of face value 2 lakh. So the proportionate amount to be cancelled is equal to 30,000. Entry for sale of investment. Bank account debit to DRR investment. Bank account debit to DRR investment. So the date write down 31st March 20X2 by bank. 30,000, and the simple trick is just write 2 lakh into 15%. 2 lakh into 15%, because 15% is what you have created. Or if you want to write like this for understanding, somewhere below nearby you write down. Okay, so now we are going to cancel own debenture. What is the face value of own debenture? 2 lakh. And what rate you have purchased? 1,98,000. First entry, debenture account debit to own debenture. 31st March 20X2 to own debenture account. Is it 2 lakh? 2,000 debenture into face value 100 rupees. 2 lakh. 2000 into 100, 2 lakh. And then I'll go to own debenture account, credit side, same date, 31st March 20X2, by what is the rate? 12%. By 12% debenture, 2 lakh. Credit side is more, debit side is less. So you write down 2, profit on cancellation. Then it comes to 2000. Profit on cancellation, balancing figure 2000. Take total of this account, 2 lakh. Right. So one account closed. Now I am going to redeem the remaining investment. So I am going to sell the remaining investment. I am going to redeem the remaining debenture. So I'm going to sell the remaining investment. What is the remaining investment now? 2,10,000. Entry for sale of remaining DRR investment. Bank account debit to DRR investment. Because the cancellation and redemption date both are same. So this 2,10,000 you sell. At par. It's written somewhere in the question. The investments were realized at par. But be careful in the exam. It may not be at par. Then this figure will change. If this will change, you will have some profit or loss. That profit or loss on sale of investment will be transferred to P&L account. Will be transferred to P&L account. Coincidentally, in all questions they have given in the material, the debentures, DRR investments were realized at par. Okay, no problem. Now you can pay this debenture. Debenture redemption, 12% debenture account debit to, you can write bank, directly you pay, or you can write debenture holder. Or you can write debenture holder. But then I have to prepare one more account. Otherwise you write to bank only. Debenture to bank. How much is remaining? 14 lakh? Is it 14 lakh? So debentures are redeemed fully. Once the debentures are redeemed, what will you do with this DRR account? Transfer to general reserve. Transfer to general reserve. To general reserve. Is it 1,40,000? 1,40,000? So how much is the total? This account is closed. DRR investment is closed. Debenture account is closed. Own debenture is closed. Okay. Only I'll give you a note for this point. Note for this point, because you have passed two entries. Write a note. On 31st March 2000 X2. On 31st March 2000 X2. Instead of passing two entries, instead of passing two entries, we can just pass one entry as the date of cancellation and the date of redemption are same as the date of cancellation and date of redemption are same. Okay. Any query now? What about interest on debenture, interest on investment? They have not asked. Second note write down, which is important than the first one. It is assumed that own debentures were acquired on X interest basis. It is assumed that own debentures were acquired on X interest basis. Own debentures were acquired on X interest basis. So we have directly taken 99 into 2000. If it is cum interest basis, you have to remove the interest from that and our answer will change. Is it right? Point number 3, write down. The profit on cancellation of debenture will be transferred to capital reserve. Profit on cancellation of debenture will be transferred to capital reserve. Profit on cancellation of debenture will be transferred to capital reserve. Okay. So notes you have written. In all question you write whatever notes are applicable. Now I am going to dictate one more question to you. So write down one question. A company has rupees 60,000, 6% debenture outstanding on 1st January 2020. 60,000, 6% debenture outstanding on 1st January 2020. Second point, right, on that date DRR stood at rupees 6000, represented by, why 6000? 10% of 60,000. DRR stood at rupees 6000, represented by rupees 9000, 3%, DRR investment. What is the 3%? This is the interest rate, okay, on investment. So opening balance is sufficient in this problem. First problem we took today, no balance. Second we took, some balance was there. Third problem, sufficient. So you don't have to make any more adjustment in DRR and DRRI at the beginning. Now write down, on 31st December 2020, on 31st December 2020, The balance at bank, after interest on investment had been received, was ₹1,15,640. After interest on investment had been received. So bank account is already debited for interest on investment. Don't increase it by interest on investment. It's already there. On that date, the investments were sold. And the debentures were paid off. This time 100% redemption, no cancellation, okay? Question is, show the necessary ledger accounts for year 2020. So when they ask you necessary ledger accounts, you have to visualize all possible accounts which you can draw and write, okay? So which are the accounts you will draw? 6% debenture account, DRR account, DRR investment account. You can draw bank also, opening interest on debenture account, interest on DRR investment account, and debenture holder account and debenture holder account. So 6 or 7 accounts will draw. So write down answer. Keep 5 to 6 lines blank in each account. 6 line, okay, in each account. First account write. So they want to test your knowledge of last year for redemption. 6% debenture account, format date particular rupees, 6 line. Second account write, DRR investment account. So we'll give it some number 1, 2, 3. DRR investment account, all accounts 6 lines. Third write down, interest on DRR investment account. Interest on DRR investment account. Third account write down, interest on DRR investment account. Interest on DRR investment account. Written. Fourth account write, debenture interest account. Debenture interest account. Debenture interest account. Fifth account write, bank account. Fifth account, bank account. And one more account will draw, two more accounts pending, DRR account. DRR account. And one last account, debenture holder account. Last account, debenture holder account. So how many accounts you have drawn? Total 7 or 8? 7. So these are the accounts usually you will be required in the last year. If there is a cancellation, one more, own debenture also. Is it right? So all of you have drawn the format neatly. Okay, can we start now? So whichever account has balances, you write down that. Debenture account, what is the balance? 60,000. And what is the date? January. So write down 1st January 2020 by balance brought down 60,000. By balance brought down 60,000. Right? And then DRR investment account also has some balance. How much? Right, 1-1-2020 to balance brought down. It is 9,000 because it is 15% of 60,000. So they have already created adequate investment. They have already created adequate investment. Jitna chahiye utna investment kar rakha hai. Then you come to this account. DRR account, 1st January 2020, by balance brought down, 6,000, by balance brought down 6,000. And in bank account also they have given balance. But in bank account the balance is given on the last day of the year, 31/12/2020, to balance brought down 1,15,640. Is it there? And this is right in bracket after interest on investment. After interest on investment. After interest on investment. Just few more interest. Problem is easy. This company will receive interest on investment. Bank account debit to interest on investment. So bank account debited, but I need to credit the interest on DRR investment. So go to the credit side. Second effect I have to write. Debit effect has gone into bank account. Debit effect has already gone into bank account. But the credit effect has to go to DRR investment. 31/12/2020 by bank. Interest rate is 3%. And investment amount is 9,000. So how much is that? 270. So write down 270. And this 270 is already there in this 115,640. Do not write 270 again. You want to write? Reduce it first by 270. Then write. Then it is okay. Now we'll pay interest also. We'll also pay interest on the debenture that we have issued. What is the rate of interest? 6%. So entry for interest paid on 31/12/2020 to bank. Debenture interest account debit to bank account, rate of interest 6%. And value of debenture 60,000. So 3,600. And bank account, we will write credit side. This question is silent about whether this balance is after paying interest on debenture or not. We don't know. So we'll write a note for that. It is before paying interest on debenture. It was after interest on investment was mentioned. What is not mentioned means I need to pass those entries. Accordingly, we'll interpret and write a note by debenture interest. Interest account debit to bank account 3,600. Okay. Now we'll sell the investment. Now we will sell the investment. At what rate? Is it mentioned in the problem? It is only written investment was sold. If nothing is given, then you sell at 9,000 only. Entry for sale of investment. Bank account debit to DRR investment. So bank account debit side to DRR investment amount 9,000. And then DRR investment account credit side 31/12/20 by bank 9,000. Total 9,000. This account closed. Bank account debit to DRR investment account 9,000. What is the next entry now? Debenture account debit to debenture holder account. Debenture account debit to debenture 31/12/2020 to debenture holder account. Sixty thousand both side. After that, we'll go to debenture holder account. The last one. 31/12/2020 by 6% debenture account. 60,000. What is the next entry now? 31/12/2020 debenture holder to bank. Debenture holder account to bank account, 60,000. Debenture holder to bank account, 60,000. And go to bank account also. Bank account, credit side, 31st December 2020, by debenture holder account. By debenture holder account, 60,000. All entries are over. Now start closing one by one. Start from the first one. First one is closed. Second is also closed. Third one, it is interest account. Where will you transfer interest account? To P&L account. To profit and loss account, 270. To profit and loss account, 270. Take total 270 both sides. Then next account is debenture interest account. 31/12/2020. What will you do with this account? By profit and loss account, 3600. Take total of both side, 3600. What will you do with this bank account, 31/12/2020? By balance, carry it down. 61,004. Check. Take the total. What is the total? 1 lakh. Write down 124,640. Write total of both sides. Bank account balance 61040 is right. It is opening balance before passing the three entries. Opening balance means balance on 31/12/2020, last day of the year. Only some redemption entries are pending. Okay. Only some redemption entry of the last day is pending. Other entries have been passed. 61,040 is right. What will you do with this balance? Now the debentures have been redeemed. You will transfer to general reserve. Transfer to general reserve. 6,000. To general reserve, 6,000. Is it right? This account is already closed. Write one note. Write one note that balance in bank account given in the question. Balance in bank account given in the question is before adjusting the following transactions. Under that one, interest paid on debenture. So this entry we have done. Second, sale of investment. And third, redemption of debenture. So these three entries we have passed in bank account. Okay. Otherwise, there was no point in giving that balance. If it was after passing all the entries, then what are we supposed to do? Nothing. So anyway, we have made our point clear. Yes, your query is resolved. Any other query? If closing balance is 1 lakh, last closing balance, then don't prepare the bank account only. If you think these entries have been passed, then there is no need to prepare the bank account. We are doing ledger counting. We are not doing mathematical problem. What was the opening balance? Is it right? So our question has been given up to a certain stage and we just have to carry it forward. Okay? We are not required to do reverse working and find opening balance. They are asking you to prepare ledger account. So just carry forward the transaction to its end. Not reverse it. Okay? So this question is over. Now, there are some summary points in your notes. Let us revise that. Debenture may create, is it there? Debenture may create a charge against some or all of the assets of the company. Charge may be fixed or floating depending upon the condition of issue. Debenture may be redeemed after a fixed number of years or after certain time period has elapsed. For redemption of debenture, company should maintain DRR account. 4. Method of redemption can be lump sum or payment in installment or purchase of debenture in the open market. Now one MCQ is also there. We'll check that. Which of the following statement is true? Three statements are there. One is true. Two are false. A debenture holder is an owner of the company. False. A debenture holder can get his money back only on the liquidation of the company. Debenture issued at a discount can be redeemed at a premium. This is possible. So write true. Third one is the right answer. First two are wrong. Why first option A is wrong? He's a creditor of the company. Why this is wrong? It is redeemable as per the terms of the issue of debenture. Not on liquidation. It can be after a certain time period. Okay, so one more trial. Which of the following statement is false? When they are asking false, means others are right. Only one is wrong. Debentures can be redeemed by payment in lump sum at the end of the specified period. This is true. Debenture can be redeemed by payment in lump sum at the end of a specified period. So this is true. So this is not our answer. Debentures cannot be redeemed during the lifetime of the company. This is false. Debentures can be redeemed by payment in annual installments. This is also possible. So which answer you will tick mark? B. Third question you cancel because that is a wrong question. Anyway, I'll tell you why it is wrong. It is based on old syllabus. So you can cancel it. Question number 3 cancel, because in 2019 there was a big change in the creation of DRR and DRRI, and the institute have not yet changed the question number 3 in the study material. Okay, so this question was based on old syllabus or old provisions, which is no longer relevant. Theory question you do yourself. So which kind of theory question they can ask in the exam? They can ask you, what is meant by redemption of debenture? Explain. And then they can ask you, write short note on DRR. So you can write now. How many pages you can write? Many? 4 or 5 pages? 2 pages? 1 page? 1 also you can't write. This chapter is over.